about giving free yoga to people in any form, but now, luckily in my career, as far as I've been playing along and doing this game, typically at places that cost a lot of money to practice, that this is my karmic gift that I want to keep giving that same class that I give for free to anyone, and not just here, but that's why we're also live streaming and recording it, so that people that aren't as lucky as us to be in the sweet spot of the universe, San Diego, can also be a part of that too. So thanks for joining me. Today we're working on building emotional freedom, and a lot of that comes mentally first. So we'll start with a core meditation to build and cultivate awareness of how to create freedom here and here, and then the movement will reinstill some of that freedom from the inside out. So let's start in a seat, whether it's on your blocks, because that does give your hips more space, and if you don't have a block per se, you can always sit on a blanket or a towel. Come up nice and tall on your spine, breathe in. Situate yourself in a way that you feel steady as you breathe out. We have over 60,000 thoughts in a day, and so many emotions come forward. As we're sitting here right now, I want you to visualize like you're driving in a sweet car, your favorite car, whatever it is, down a stretch of highway like Route 66. And as you're driving this car, you have the right amount of sun on your face, the right amount of wind. Maybe it's a sweet convertible. Imagine that all of the things that the little versions of yourself, tired you, happy you, strong you, empowered you, all of these little versions of you and your emotions and your thoughts are like kids in the back seat, yelling and screaming how they feel. And you're just chilling, you're in control, you're in the driver's seat. But all of a sudden, one of those little versions of you, whatever you're feeling right now, comes and sits in the passenger seat right next to you. Take a full body scan. What emotion, what thought is coming to the front seat right now? And then without judging that thought, that feeling, that emotion, just gently say, hey, I love you. Thanks for joining the party. Take a back seat. And we keep riding. We're back in control. Free flow and that sunshine on your face. Oh, it feels so good to be here in this present moment. And then something else comes up like it always does. Maybe it's hungry you, distracted you, tight you, sore you. What's coming up? What's sitting in that passenger seat next to you? Teacher in our lives. Thank you. I love you. Whatever's there, now take a back seat. Remaining in control of what's coming forward, what you feel and what you think, is our biggest power in this lifetime. Because it doesn't matter what thoughts come up. We're going to have some weird ass thoughts. But what does matter is the meaning that you give to them. Just notice them. Thanks for that, teacher. And take a back seat. Start to cultivate a breath that's strong and vital for you today. What does it feel like to empower your body top to bottom with that breath? Inhale. Exhale. Then gently take your palms over your head. Roll forward into tabletop. In our tabletop today, spread all of your fingers really wide. Feel that sensation of rooting deep into your mat, and as you hold tabletop, plant each finger very intentionally. So let's go pinky first, then ring finger, then middle finger, pointer and thumb. And activate Hasta Bandha, tug back on your fingertips so that the pads of your fingers press hard into the mat and the peace finger knuckles press down. Now, once you have a nice grip, like you're holding two jars of jelly, make some circular rotations around and around. Move from your shoulder to girdle, but keep your hand grip really strong and steady, pushing into the pads and the peace finger knuckles. Use your whole hand, that's gonna take tension out of your wrist. Awesome, now hold your tabletop and close your eyes. Imagine that each of your fingers was a different thought and emotion. What do you wanna plant, what vibration into this room today? Think of five things that you wanna feel. Maybe you wanna feel strong, that's your pinky. Maybe you wanna feel confidence, that's your ring.
Think of vibrations that you want to bring to this room and energetically, mentally plant them like you're pressing your fingers into a fertile ground with seeds. Taking the space to set your intention in your state. Breathe power into your hands. Inhale. Keep that hand grip. Downward facing dog. Fly all the way back. Feeling length through your back. Energy through your upper body. Invite in all of those good vibrations now from your fingers into your heart. Tracing up through the head to the hips. Inhale. Forward fold. Top of the mat. Hangs so easy that your back, oh, it feels like it's just a towel drying over a railing in the wind. There's no tension in your back, head, or neck. You can roll forward or back in your feet. And if it's hard to reach your abs to your thighs, no problem. Bend your knees a lot so that your strong abs touch your strong thighs. Awesome. Finding more length through your back is critical for what's coming next. Walk your palms forward so that your palms plant. So it's almost like a half down dog, half forward fold. Here's the idea today. Instead of taking a halfway lift, you're going to come to the place where your palms plant and you roll onto your tippy toes so the weight goes into your hands. Try that a few times. Roll back into your heels and then roll back into your hands. Depending on your hamstring flexibility, you might be a little farther apart, but what's critical is your palms plant. When you feel the weight distributed to your palms, that's your time to activate your back muscles. So you're pushing up. Even just this little simple action is toning all the muscles it takes to do a press up or a handstand, keeping your posture strong. Nice alignment, Nat. Roll back weight into your heels, forward fold. Chair pose, inhale, sit on down. Drop the weight into your heels and lighten your toes. Big breath in. Air clean your arms and open your shoulders. Interlace your fingertips behind your chest expansion. Big breath. Chest to thighs, you can keep your knees bent, tick-tock your arms left and right. Building dynamic shoulder flexibility in that ball and socket joint. Every time you come to a sticky space, right, a stuck space in the muscle of the fascia, talk to it, be like, hey, I'm ready for this resistance. It's coming in the front seat, yeah, I see you, you're a teacher, thank you. And I'm gonna breathe through that resistance, take a back seat. Unbind the hands, stand up, mountain pose, look up at your hands, big breath. Forward fold, exhale, reach for the earth with bent knees. Now here we go, here's our drill. Halfway lift, walk your hands forward so that the weight is in your hands. Layer one, you're just gonna stay here. Layer two, start to alternate and butt kick. Left heel to butt, right heel to butt. Keep pushing up. Lock out your elbows so the action comes from your back muscles and less from your shoulders. The minute you bend your elbows, you're doing a lot more shoulder work. Good than that. Keep rolling the weight into your fingers. Last four. If this feels challenging on your hamstrings, walk your feet back a little further. That's okay. Last two. Step back, high plank. Push up, go halfway down. Upward facing dog, left and right. Stretch all the way up through your core muscles. Big breath in. Exhale, child's pose, roll back. Let your head rest down. Reaffirm here, what's coming to the front seat? What emotions, what thoughts are sitting next to you in that passenger seat? Without judgment, our job now is not even giving it deep meaning. Just ask yourself, hey, thank you for that lesson, thought, emotion. You're entertaining. I'm ready to drive forward. Take a back seat. This is my life and I decide what meaning I give to everything that happens. Breathe in. Downward dog, we're gonna flow it. Before we move into our Surya Namaskara A, the option is to take a hop forward and practice your handstands. So you can stay in your down dog to tone your shoulders, or look forward, bend your knees, and try to hover your hips over your hands a few times. Doesn't matter if you stick a handstand, just play with a little donkey kick. Try to get some hover time, hips over hands. That was beautiful. Nice hand. Keep bringing your hands. Get that hang time. Bent knees is fine. I want you to see your butt hang over your hands. Straight alignment. Hips over fingers for three. Awesome. Hold. Ready. Two. Everyone bend your knees. Forward fold. Top of the mat. Let's blow it. Chair pose. Breath in.
Exhale, airplane squeeze. Interlace your arms. Inhale, open your chest. Chest to thighs. Exhale. Mountain pose. Look up. Inhale. Forward fold. Bend your knees to reach. Halfway leg variation. Put the weight in your hands. Exhale, chaturanga or donkey kick your way back. Slow and steady down through chaturanga. Child's pose. Hold and breathe. It's important to me that we reset. We just did an awesome prana building flow, energy, breath to movement. Realign what's in the front seat.
It's not about how you handstand. It's about how you treat yourself when it gets a little challenging and resisting. Inhale, tuck your toes.
Exhale, down we go.
Same dance, look forward. Either donkey kick or step to forward fold, top of the mat. Inhale, chair squat, drop your butt. Airplane, squeeze your triceps and interlace. Inhale, little chest expansion. Chest up, eyes over your head. Inhale, rise up, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold, reach and extend. Inhale, halfway up, with the weight into your hands. Exhale, hop back, chaturanga or donkey kick. If you're taking that hop back leg with bent elbows, breathe in. Child's pose and hold. Awesome place to stay and reset. If challenge is ready for your front seat, put weight into your palms, either forearm plank or headstand. Forearms down, crown of your head to the earth. You can alternate butt kicks, just like we started class with. That's great for your hamstrings. Or if you're ready, lift one leg up, find that center of balance, and lift straight up. Cultivate a core awareness that is undeniably present. Whether you're choosing forearm plank or headstand on your forearms, remember, it takes a crazy amount of core awareness. Pull your elbows into shoulder width distance. Remember, eventually you're gonna lift your head out of this. Your head's literally gonna come off the ground, so arms hold the majority of the weight. Awesome alignment, Leanna. 8, 7, hold a little bit stronger in whatever you're squeezing, your quads, your abs, your core. 4, 3, I love the offset, Debbie. 2, downward dog. All right, let's add. Straight arms, right leg high. Big breath in. Open your hip to create a little space. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Warrior 1, spin your back foot down. Shorter than a crescent, so your hips are in a nice parallel line. Tug your left hip forward to stretch your quad. Big breath in. Open twist to the right, squeeze. Tee out your arms. As you hold this alignment, just like that, squeeze your back muscles together. Pretend you were high-fiving that sidewall by pushing into your palm. Exalted, crescent, inhale, look up, lift up, big breath in. Hold here, interlace your left hand to meet the right. Either lay against your back or start to drift down your sacrum, look up and back. Feel the back bend, accentuate all of the strength building in your neck. Awesome, inhale, let your neck, even throat hang open. As long as you have no neck sensitivity, it's gonna build the cervical muscle stronger. Humble warrior, exhale, dive your heart down inside of your right leg. As your palms come up and over your head, ask your shoulders to be a little stronger and deeper as your thumbs drive towards the mat over your head. Every day, be conditioned to just be a little bit better, a little bit stronger, a little bit more flexible. But it also comes with a conscious communication, right? Maybe what's in your passenger seat right now is saying, ooh, my shoulders can't go any farther. Thank you, resistance as a teacher. Take a back seat, let me try again. Ooh, my leg loves this fire. Thank you, fire, as a teacher. Just entertainment for my consciousness. Take a back seat. I feel like I'm more patient. All the way up, inhale. Warrior 1, lift all the way up. You're like, what's in my front seat? Shut the hell up. Standing still. Lift your left leg. Awesome. Now, the same drill we just practiced when we did our halfway lift is the same drill we're going to do with one leg now. Walk your hands forward, plant them in any capacity. So you may have to step your right foot back, stay on your mat. Good, Adriana. Now, put all the weight in your fingers. Remember the hand grip we started with. Flex your fingers, bend at the knuckle, make sure your palms are touching. Grip the mat like you're holding 2 jars of jelly. Hold it, tippy toes. Hold it. Look through your right inner thigh. Look up through your pelvic muscles. Push away from the ground.
grip your hand so hard that it already feels like you're in a handstand. It should feel challenging on your back. This is a conditioning technique.
Palms are still planted, three. Palms are still planted, push up, push away from the ground, straighten your arms, two.
Exhale, step back, low lunge. Half splits. If you want to use your blocks for assistance, they're great arm and leg extenders. Full splits is always an option if you want to challenge your flexibility in your hamstrings. I'm going to demonstrate a transition that we'll work on in the flow. Super simple in technique, but not as easy to apply when we're building this back strength. So from our standing splits, like we just practiced, walk your hands forward enough that you can be all of the weight in your hands. In the flow, option one, you'll lift up, kick up a little bit, step back and chaturanga. That's cool. Option two is an L hop. Hop up and up, hop the right foot back for a chaturanga, then upward dog. Last layer, if you are working that handstand, put all the weight into the hands. Try your best to get that alignment point. Maybe third time's a charm. Once you get up, it's about the hover point on the way down. So it's straight on the way up, and then bent on the way down. Either way, whether you're trying to get that hover point and hold, or you're just conditioning your back to do the hop, straight on the way up, bend on the way down. Let's go back to standing splits and we'll try that drill. Hands down, tighten your hamstrings, walk your foot back farther. That's okay. Now, hop up one or two times, and if you don't feel confident on your hands today, no problem. Just do a little baby kick and hop your right foot back and land in a push-up. So you're kicking off that right foot, right? Yeah, good. Downward dog, we made that. Exactly. That was great. I love it. You just hop off that back foot. Good, Leanna. Inhale, upward and downward. Let's get there. Breathe in. Breathe out. Yay. What's in the front seat? Inhale. It's just entertainment for my consciousness. Inhale, so good. Left leg high. Breathe in. Open a little bit. Wiggle your toes. From top to bottom, wiggle from your left pinky toe to your big toe. Low lunge. Inhale, warrior one. Activate your arms even here. So your arms are fierce. They're an expression of the handstand already even here. As you activate the delts, your lats get longer, building strength and shoulder flexibility. Breathe in. Open to the left. Hold. Stay deep into the lunge and power your heart to open as your shoulders drop. It's easy to open your heart if you're all closed off and like not letting anything in. But if you can open your heart and open your shoulders back, allowing the gate to open, there's a lot more space to breathe. Inhale, back bend, right palm to the sky, exalted, left palm down. Your left palm can hold stability and support. Keep pushing your chest forward, back it up. Breathe in. Exhale, interlace your right hand to your left. If you were in a deep back bend, especially in the flow, look back forward before you do it. Reinterlace so your neck is safe. Inhale, look up, drip, lift. Hug your pubic muscles up so the energy is not sinking down, but instead it's buoyant and lifting you up. Breathe in, exhale, dive into your hip, humble warrior. It's so crazy. When I was ranting on the other side, we're never gonna get that moment back. Look at us now, we're in a new side, a new moment, a new opportunity to see what part of our emotions are taking that front seat. Do a little self-scan. Thank you, I love you emotion. Thank you, I love you thought. I'll take a back seat. I'm back in control. I got this moment, it's brand new. Inhale, crescent, rise back up, or warrior one rather. Arms up, breathe in. Awesome. Exhale, standing splits. Fire your hands to the ground. So you'll notice in the flow, you may want to start your initial warrior one more towards the center of your mat. Awesome. Stay there. Take the drill. Walk your hands forward. Good, Hannah. Come onto that back tippy toe. So you're a little close. Bring your left foot further back so you have some space. Yeah. Come onto the tippy toe of your left foot. Lift and squeeze your right glute. Look through your left pubic bone up. Awesome. I like the head tilt change, Reggie. Lift. Put the weight in your hands. Put the weight in your hands. Step back to half or full splits. Good job, guys. Breathe. life into that space. Half your full splits are great. I'll demo this one more time. So the idea is, yes, you can do just a little kick and step back. Sure. Great. Or hopefully, right up point, no knee sensitivity. As you lift up and kick up, you can just bend your elbows and land with that left foot back, meeting an upward dog. If you're working the hover point, you may even take more time to lift up and take a few kicks, kind of like I did, that's okay too. Finding that hover point in your back. Breathe in, then gently come down. The longer you hold it, the better, but keep your core muscles into protective. Let's play together. Standing splits, go back into that drill. Hands flat, do a few kick-ups, or just do your little hop back. Palms are planted, hop the left foot back and land in a push-up. Hop the left foot back and land in a push-up. Awesome. The slower on the way down, the better. Beautiful. Downward facing dog. So good, guys. Breathe in. Patience with the body as you breathe out. Two more breaths to reaffirm that vibration. Remember when we planted seeds in your mat? Come back to some of those seeds. Inhale. Exhale. Let's do it. Right leg high, we dance a little bit. Exhale, short low lunge to the center of your mat. Warrior one, inhale, launch your arms up. Exhale, open twist to the right. Exalted, lift your left palm high for a back bend. Exhale, take the left palm behind you to meet the right, interlace. Bigger back bend, inhale, look up. Exhale, humbled warrior, drop down and in. Inhale, back to warrior one, use your core to stand up. Exhale, standing splits, hold there. Inhale is kick up or hold. Push up, chaturanga, hop or step back. Good. Back row, you're looking awesome. Downward facing for your abs. Left leg high. Exhale, short lunge, center of your mat. Warrior one, pull your abs in to stand up. Exhale, twist to the left. Back bend, look up through the right hand, trace your gaze. Hands deep behind you, exhale. Inhale, expand your shoulders and chest. Exhale, drop into that humble warrior. Inhale, warrior one, using your core to lift. Exhale, hands to the mat, standing splits. Now put the weight into your hands. Inhale, handstand, kick up or hold. Hop back, step back, chaturanga, land with bent elbows. Inhale. Exhale, downward dog. Yeah, right leg high. Good power, guys. Short, low lunge. Strong in your warrior one. Virabhadrasana, lift up. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, exalted. Exhale, hands come to it. Empower your heart open. Exhale, humbly dive into your hip. Inhale, warrior one, fierce arms up and strong. Exhale, standing splits, plant your palms like suction cups. Kick up, lift up. Push up, float back. Good, Nat, I love it. That one-legged hop back is so good for your quads. Down dog. Left leg, breathe in, last little part of the flow. Low lunge, empty all of your air. Warrior one, breath in, twist back. Exalted, the biggest one, yes. Use your inner thighs up. Interlace with grace. Hands behind you. Crack your sternum open. Humbly dive down in your strong legs. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, hands to the mat. Weight in your palms. Start to tone your back like that. Exhale, float back. Awesome, Sarah. Good alignment. Downward dog, breathe everything out. Every exhale is an opportunity for you to do an abdominal crunch. Stay present, reactivate the hand grip. Listen carefully, press your pinkies harder into the mat. Press your ring finger harder into the mat. Your middle finger, pointer finger, and your thumb. Bend in that knuckle so your pads press harder down and reactivate the seeds, the vibrations we've planted. Inhale. Exhale. Right leg high again, breath in. Exhale, runner's lunge. Drive your right foot to the outer parts of your hands. Hold steady. If it's accessible to drop your back knee down, go there. Or maybe your left forearm and right forearm will come down too. The intention right now is left quadricep flexibility, the top of your left leg and the outer right thigh.
awesome and great place to stay. Or if you want to build a little bit more inner thigh flexibility, take it to like a lizard. You'll wiggle your right foot towards the top right edge of your mat like an offset split. Breathe and hold. Locks are great options. Under your butt, under your hands. Breathe and reset. What's in the front seat? Our greatest power is not in being able to control your thoughts, but in knowing which ones serve you, because you're never going to stop them from coming in. But the filter at which you listen, that gives us the emotional and mental freedom that we're seeking. Creating that space within the internal structure happens also from that external structure. Thank you, flexibility, for building with every single breath. Wiggle your right foot back into center. Take your time if you're in that deep stretch. Back to warrior one. Fire your quads up, spin the back foot down, and stretch your ankle. Breathe in, arms up. Exhale, warrior one twist. Left elbow to the outer right thigh. Now leverage your gaze past your right elbow in such a way that you almost lose your breath. It's actually kind of hard to breathe. And then once you get to that spot, talk to the diaphragm muscles. See if you can reinvigorate them to breathe deeper, even though it feels stuck or tight when you twist. Energy pulsing from the back left heel all the way through the crown of your head. Turn mainly from your torso as you engage and push into your elbow. Lower body stays pulled into that. Now look down at your right big toe. Stay or lift your back leg off the mat for revolved low flyer. As you push your elbow delicately against your leg, feel that strength happening from the inside. Twist and revolve your gaze up to challenge your balance. I got this, I got this. Three. Two. Hands to the mat, standing splits. Big breath in. Fifth. Ooh, squeeze, hold. Left heel to butt. Take your right hand to your back foot. Rise to revolve dancer's pose. Lift all the way up. Finding your strength from your right ankle. It's going to get a break in about 10 seconds. Do you want to challenge your awesome depth and awareness? Reach your heart forward and your left arm up. Keep lifting. Find space in your heart to look up. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Bend your knees, forward fold. Ragdoll is wider. Let everything go as wide as your mat. Hang loose. Wiggle your feet wide as your mat. Heels in, toes out, frog velocity. So as you drop into your frog, you can stay, of course, and feel really good space in your hips. It's awesome to restore. Blocks are a great arm extenders too. I'm going to show you the drill for a half moon drill. Right toes in, and you'll swing your left leg up and out. Swing it back in. Notice that I'm going from internal rotation to external rotation, almost like I'm squeezing my left outer butt cheek. Pull it in. Open up strong. If you feel confident in your balance, you can also keep the block under your right hand. You start from this forward fold position and expand up and lift up like a drill. Inhale, come back through, back to that forward fold position and lift. All right, team, right leg down, left foot comes in. Tense your left toes as a kickstand. This is your starting position. Bend your left knee. Layer one, both hands on both blocks or one block, kick up and back. That's cool. Lead with your left outer thigh. Or layer two, half moon drills, take an open stretch. Come back down, close your hip, pull your abs in, tap those left ball mount toes down. Repeat a few times on your own. What you're doing is toning the outer part of your hip, your upper glute meat. You don't have to go fast, just go as slow as makes you feel strong. Keep breathing space in the outer butt. Yes. Now this muscle action takes us into our next pose. Meet me in a wide-legged ragdoll.
right arm tucks inside of your legs. Tap your right butt cheek with your right hand. There you go. You can slap it. And then your left hand behind you. Right hand grabs left. Take your full bind with your left arm behind your back. That's good, Kev. Look over your left shoulder. Perfect. Ground through your left foot. Go to the tippy toes of your right. All right, perfect place to stay. Or rise up to Birds of Paradise. Playing with the same body structure we had in Lizard or Runner's Lunge. This is Runner's Lunge with a little bit of a bind challenge. And lift and extend. We're going back to our leg lift drills. You can go back to where we started with the blocks, or keep your arms bound, revolved half moon. Lift your back left leg up, bound revolved half moon, or hands to the block, hold it bound for full half moon. Everybody, 8, 7, nice nap. Same action, your muscles remember it now. It's muscle memory now. Amplify it. 3, good set, 2, step back, reverse triangle. Inhale, lift up, right arm high. Exhale, triangle pose, lean in. Pull your abs in, look up at your left hand. If you want to play with lateral spinal strength, stay, you're already doing great work for your obliques. Or, bottom hand reaches forward, top hand gives it a high five. Go back to where you started, back to where you started. Repeat, reach the right hand, flat the left hand, back up, and lower down. Do a few of those. Playing with your core, right? And slow. I want to be able to balance like a glass of wine on your side. So keep that left side parallel to the mat. My triangle holds, you've got about 10 seconds left. You're doing great. Beautiful alignment. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, cross arena toes in, heels out, just hang loose. Prasarita is such a great way to stretch your inner outer thighs. Awesome. A little bit more of drill sensation because that's the idea to create freedom and strength. Plant your palms down, just like we've been practicing the whole class. Wiggle your right foot more to center. Come to the tippy toe of your right foot only. Hug your left knee up and in. Left knee in, tuck your left big toe in towards your glute, almost like frog. Inhale, tap your left toes down in a circular motion. Exhale, bring it back up to that almost frog position. Tap it down, hip mobility in your left. Trying to build your press up muscles. Last 3. Big circle. Yeah, that's good. Those are awesome. 2. Oh, booty. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, low lunge to plank position. Maybe a plank. This is your last plank of the day. Last challenge for your core. Your beautiful choice is to stay present and happy or taking your donkey kicks. Last opportunity to play with all of that strength we've built. Bend your knees like you played and try to hover your hips over your hands. Aiming to get that hang time or holding your handstand. Everybody, 8, 7, 6. If you're holding that handstand, straighten up, push out of the ground. 3, 2. Left leg high, breathe in, good job. Exhale, short, low lunge. Last standing set, warrior one, breath in. Exhale, palms in prayer, twist left. Push hard on the outer thigh. Activate and hug already, even before. Now you kind of know a lift of that leg. Before we take that launch point, hug your pubic muscles up to protect all of the low back muscles. Look down on your left big toe. Lift your back leg up. Core awareness and stability, yes. Your left ankle is getting stronger. This is preventative medicine to protect you from injuries in the future. Strong stabilizer muscles. Optional look up to challenge the proprioception. Hold, breathe. Standing splits, fire your leg up, lift it. Inhale. Heel to your booty. Revolved, dancer's pose. Lift up, lift up. Find that sweet balance point as your heart lifts. sensation, a thought. Cool. Focus on that one thing. Feeling that one thing helps us drown out other things. Focus, focus, focus. I'm right here. Breathe in. Bend your knees, wide-legged forward fold, and rock your body left and right. Let's go shoulder flexibility. Keep walking your shoulders, your hands in between your thighs as much as you can. Walk back, walk back, walk back so that your head pokes up in between your thighs. Awesome. What if your back of your shoulders could be on the outside of your knees, like on the back edge? Keep peekabooing your gaze up. Yeah, that was right. With that drill, left foot down, right toes tippy toe. Inhale, kick up and out. Exhale, pull it back in. Or taking a little deeper, half moon lift. Then exhale, pull it back in, hold your abs in. You're on your own for a few drills. Little tiny tiptoes, right toes in, kick up and out and expand. I don't want you to go fast. I want you to go to the extent that you're feeling your strength in your inner thighs, flexibility in your hips. It would have helped if we had had that runner's, huh? Step your right foot back. Let's go to runner's lunge. Let's go there first, because the lizard is pretty important to that movement. You're not just works on your left side, I swear it's my fault. Sarah's got the full lizard, Nat's got the runners. Just breathe. Let this be a time for you to experience space, for you to experience what it feels like to be more open, even if your body's resistant to it. Gently bring that left foot back in. All right, let's re-drill. Inhale, kick up and open, maybe a little bit more open. Tuck your knee in. Or half moon, align that left block. Block with your left hand and left foot. Keep your left toes tipped forward. Come back in. Awesome, hey, right? When you hit it, like for a second, it feels like that beautiful extension. You're like, oh yeah, that's what it feels like to be in balance. And just as quickly as it comes, it goes. All right, team, wide-legged forward fold. Drop your left arm under, tap your left booty, then wrap your right hand behind, grab a hold, straighten your legs, stay there. If that feels awesome, great. Or put the weight in your right foot, start to gently lift up. Stay expansive with a bent foot, kind of like the birds of paradise have. The
little beak, those flowers, or lift up and extend up. Point your toes, but fan them. So it's a point, like a Barbie foot. Extend through the ball mound, fan your toes. Breathe in. Gently bring it down. Keep your left foot on the ground. Fully bound, half moon, lift the right leg up. And maybe it's a few tacks today. Maybe you don't stick it at the top, you just kick up flat. Kick up and back. Wow. Maybe fall out of it. Half moon's a great place to stay. Three breaths. If you've got that beautiful bound half moon, lift your head up with your back foot. Your head or your leg stays at the height of your hip. Just like half moon. Three. Two. Reverse triangle. Plant your back right foot. Lift up the back. Breathe in. Trikonasana, triangle. Make that three pointed space. Stay and engage through your inner thighs. Or core drill, take your left arm forward. Right arm comes to high five it. Come back over your head. Replace the left palm on your shin and repeat. Shift forward. In an ideal scenario for your core, your head, just like Natalie's, is aligned with your right hip. Very challenging, I understand. Stay with a space where you feel challenged but also safe. That you notice what's in the front seat is like, F you, but then also what's in the front seat is like, I think I can. Like, I think if I just dig a little deeper, I can. Last three. Yeah, reach whatever you got. Let's get two. Star pose, big breath in. Exhale, prasarita, bow in. Take an arm variation that makes you feel good, supported. Four. Palms to the earth. Wiggle your left foot in, working that kind of last drill we'll do on your hands. Swing the right leg up into an offset frog, swing it back down. Left tippy toes, swing it up, put the weight in your hands. Big circle back down. Ideally your palms are planted, that whole drill we've been doing this whole time. Good. Hips are ready. Toes are trusting. Good. Circular swing. Good. And you can do like almost a circle with your hip. Circle it up. Feel it up. There you go. Good. Beautiful. Back to prasarita team. Breathe in. Head down. Breathe out. Wiggle into a low lunge in front of your mat. Half pigeon. Just wiggle your left foot across your body and hang out in half pigeon. Lift your head up. Inhale. Relax your body down and forward as you exhale. Enjoy the pigeon stretch. We'll be in this first part of it for about 90 seconds. Now more than ever, we acknowledge from top to bottom what's coming up. I start to talk a lot less in this part of the class as you start to listen to the important part more, yourself. Thank you. gently to your palms.
Left arm swings behind you to grab your right heel. Heel to butt. Grab it.
Stay right there because it's perfect. Here, lock can be like a pillow too. Take your right arm and thread it under so that you're still, you can re-grab your leg and hold it. Twisted. Half pigeon. If the ground feels far away, you can put your hand on the block. The block is many different heights. Get a little bit deeper quad stretch. Now a little fun transition. You might want to make sure there's nothing to your left. Come back up through pigeon. Roll so that your right arm, you're going to go right, and your right arm opens. Left leg keeps going, and you're supine twisting as you gaze to your left. So your arms go right first, then open your right arm like a T. Yep, keep going, Reggie. And then left leg comes all the way over. Supine twist, move left. Awesome. Breathe. Spacing your heart and chest happens with all of this good gravity working in your favor. There are so many times where I'll be frustrated or busy or whatever my default emotion is to not really just be in the present. But our power, and it doesn't happen all the time, comes from just noticing when you reset to a different space, like, oh man, I see frustrated in the front seat, but that's not me. I see it, I recognize it, it's a teacher. But I'm different than what I feel. I'm not what I feel and I'm not what I think. I'm something a little bit deeper. The witness that's watching those things, that's watching your emotions, watching being frustrated, watching being hungry. And then as you see it, you take your power back by taking the meaning away from it. It's not me, it's not real. I experienced it. Thank you. Let's take a back seat and move forward. Last little part is cat pulling its tail. So just as you are, your right foot's already set up for success. Left hand grabs your bottom foot. Your right hand grabs that left leg that's twisted. If you want a little bit more for the IT band, straighten your left leg and hold your straight left leg in a twist. Your bottom right foot is kicking to your booty. Hold, but it's being held by your left hand. Cat pulling its tail. Breathe in. Bend both knees back in. Just roll onto your belly facing in front of the room in any way that makes you feel easy. Half pigeon on the other side. Right leg through. Bow down. Breathe. Where can you let a little bit of space in between your thoughts? I'm breathing in. Focus on the way it feels. Like you're smelling your favorite cup of coffee. Or your morning scent, flowers, lavender. Not taking for granted a second of the fact that we're breathing. It is a gift, not a given. Thank you.
get an inhale. They exhale and never inhale again.
What a cool thing it is that we got another inhale to discover the meaning to our breath, our life, even just this day. Every time that my head gets a little bit crazy, when there's like 17 bad people sitting in the front seat with me, I ask myself, if I were to die a year from now and I knew it, how would I treat today differently? How would I show up in my presence the way that I spoke to people, saw people?
That quad stretch. Get your right hand behind you.
Let your left arm be at any level, whether it's high, low. Good. Revolve the thread, the needle, if you liked that, on the other side. Get a little bit of a spinal twist. Yeah, good. Five pieces of shape. You'll notice that this is the same action for cat pulling its tail, which comes later. Then up to your palms. Walk your hands left. Roll on your back. Twist right knee over. Look right. Stack your right hip all the way up on top of your left so that we can feel the pull happening from the outer right booty, your IT band, the connective muscle there. Stay there and enjoy that twist, or cat pulling its tail. Take your left heel into your butt, grab it with your right hand. Extend your right leg out straight and strong. Hold it with your left hand. Good. If you want a little bit more neck flexibility, look to the right. Breathe in. Onto your back, knees to your chest. Pull your abs in, rock side to side.
One final bridge or wheel pose. Let's make the back bend like an offering though.
Whether it's bridge or wheel, it's a back bend, it's a beautiful heart opener. Let's give out the good energy and strength we've cultivated this whole class. Invite in a vibration of giving so that someone that maybe isn't as lucky as us to be here can feel that too. Think of them as you lift your heart up. 30 seconds from here. Hold. Bridge or wheel. My wheels, you might be open enough to come down to forearm wheel. Creating space for grace as you push the heart up. Inhale, inhale. Hold, exhale, breathe. One last little jolt. Inhale, lift. Inhale, lift. Extend your arms and legs into full Shavasana, corpse pose. Let everything relax.
Give me a few moments of your time to be the observer without expectation, to watch what's floating in and to watch what's floating out. As you watch the soundtrack, the video recording of your day and your life and your mind play over and over and over, the less connected and attached you are to what you're actually feeling and thinking, the more you can watch it and observe it,
the more you're able to narrate and dictate the meaning that's important to you about it. This morning I woke up with a lot of goals. I had a lot of things hoping that I could get done this morning before I had an interview and then this. And when I woke up, I wasn't ready for it. My vibration wasn't there. So I noticed, without judgment, that I was feeling irritated, feeling tired. And I took a moment, just like you are now. I laid in all of my glory and all of my greatness. And I thought about a time that I was sick, like with the flu. And then all of a sudden, being grateful for who you are now, that you don't have the flu, that you're healthy enough to be here. My body flooded with a nice sensation and emotion of gratitude. I recognized that gratitude as my power. And then I thought about something else that I have right now that I didn't have a year ago. Maybe my nephews that I'm so proud of. Or even the fact that my smile works. I don't have Bell's palsy anymore. My face isn't paralyzed. And then again, my state came to gratitude. As we notice the negative emotions and thoughts, you can also notice the positive ones and how they influence you too. Taking back the pen, the narrative on your life, let this last 30 seconds in stillness be one where you write the script for how you want to take your day. And anything that's happened before this moment, narrate it as it worked in your favor. Give meaning that's more than just it happened, but that it happened for you. Your arms over your head in a big stretch.
Pull your knees to your chest. Roll gently to your side. Fetal pose.
Press to a seat facing the front. Pull your knees into that same meditation we started class with. Hands to your heart. Come back to the driving metaphor with me. Be back on Route 66 with me in your favorite car. And as you sit here tall in your posture, without judgment, just notice what's coming up. Thank you, thought or sensation. Thank you, emotion. I see you. I love you. Take a back seat. Guide your palms from your heart to your third eye, establishing that connection between the two. Breathe in. Namaste.
Namaste.
You know, like I wish that if we did one set of crunches one time or one bicep curl one day, that like we'd always have a bicep or we'd always have a six pack or that one time we ate healthy for a day that it would last too. Right? It's not like you're a mom, you have your kid, and boom, you're a good mom. You have to practice being a good mom, or boom, you have a good friendship once, and then you have to always, you're always a good friend. You have to practice it. And I can't establish enough in myself that, okay, yes, it's a concept I've learned and maybe practiced once, but we have to recondition that same concept notion, whatever it is we're working on, what makes us happy in every part of our lives. So yes, this class might, in some ways, I know a lot of you,
seem like something you've heard before. But isn't it interesting too that like it's a brand new moment and how you can take it now versus the time you've heard something like it before? That every down dog can be different. That every warrior two can be different because you've never been exposed to that moment and that lesson that it has to give. So my offering is keep rediscovering that for yourself. See what makes you come alive in the practice of conditioning all of this that we have to offer. If you guys have questions, I'll be around a little bit later. If you're watching this online, leave them. We'll answer you this week. Otherwise, thank you for coming, and I'll see you guys next week for personal freedom. Cool. Good job today, guys. You're welcome. If you guys are staying for the handstand clinic, what I do for the next, this is four, there's three more weeks after this. For the next 45 minutes from 1:15 to 2, it's a handstand clinic, it's $20, and you stay and I give you private conditioning techniques to work on your handstand or forearm or whatever arm balances you're working on. You can also just come to that, you don't have to come to this part, this is just kind of a warm up to get you there, and I leave you with tips and tricks. So just know that for the following weeks, or if you're staying, cool, let me know.
1:15 to 2. Mm-hmm.